Dear student, in today's class or today's session, I'm going to discuss another examples on the RH criterion. RH criteria. This is also very important type of problem. Here the construct the here also the characteristic equation of the system is given and ask you to find out the determine the number of roots of lying on the right half of the S plane, left half of the S plane on imaginary axis. The construct the root array and determine the stability of the system whose characteristic equation C is means characteristic equation is now this is a sixth order equation. Therefore, there are six roots. Among these six roots, so how many number of roots are lying on the right half of the S plane and how many roots are lying on the left half of the S plane or imaginary axis? We need to find out those things. So as usual manner, we need to construct the root array. Here, solution. Write down the characteristic equation. Now, the characteristic equation of the system is the CE of the system. The characteristic equation is. Now, write down the characteristic equation. Now, this is the characteristic equation. S power 6 plus 2 into S power 5 plus 8 S to the power of 4. Plus 1 s cube plus 20 s square plus 16 s plus 16 into s power 0 is equal to 0. Now this is the characteristic equation. Now by utilizing the coefficients of the characteristic equation, so form the root array. The root array is, therefore the root array can be formed as follows. The root array is how to form. Now highest powers of s is the even number. S is equal to 6, so the highest powers of s is 6, so 6 is the even number. So therefore the first row can be formed by s power 6 row can be formed by even powers of s. So now even powers of s are, this is even powers, s square is the even power, 16 into s s to the power 0. Therefore, the coefficient of s power 6 is equal to 1. Therefore, 8 is s to the power of 4 is 8. The coefficients of s square is 20. And this value is equal to 16. Therefore, the next row, s to the power of 5. The first row can be formed by even powers of coefficients of even powers of s. So, and the next row can be formed by odd powers of s. Now, what is the odd power? S to the power of 5, s to the power of 3, s to the power of 1. Now, 16s to the power of 16 into s to the power of 1. That's the coefficients of the s to the power of 5 is 2. Therefore, here, what will be the here? Is it 1? And this is 16. The remaining element is 0. Now, how to form the next row? S to the power of can be formed by utilizing the previous 4 row element. So, therefore, the s to the power of 4 element is equal to 2 into 8 of 2 into 8 of minus. So, 1 into 12 low divided by 1 into 12 divided by this 2. Therefore, this is equal to again 2. Again, we will get 2. And again, we will get a 1 here also. Therefore, 2 into 20. Therefore, again, next element is 2. For 2 into 20, 2 into 20 minus 1 into 16 divided by 2. Therefore, the year we will get again 12. Here, the again we will get the 12. Therefore, the next element is similarly, if you compute 2 into 60, now this into divided by this is equal to next is 2 into 60 divided by minus 0 divided by 2, then we will get the 60. No. Now, similarly, if I form the S cube row, Now what will be the S cube raw element? How to form S cube raw element? Now this can be 2 into 12, 2 into S cube element is equal to 1 into 12 minus 2 into 12 divided by 2. Now this is equal to, now what will be the, is equal to 0 0, and this also 0, and this also 0. While forming the root array, now this is the another difficulty 2. While forming the root array, if first element of the any row becomes 0, then that can be replaced by smallest epsilon number row, and as usual manner construct the root array and letting epsilon tends to 0, observe the first column of the root array, then we go for saying whether the system is stable or not. Here, if all the elements of the root array becomes, if difficulty 2, when all the elements in any one row of root array is 0, this condition indicates that there are the symmetrically located roots on the S-plane. No? If all the elements in the root array become 0, then there is a then there is a possibility of symmetrically located roots on the S-plane. No? Then there is a possibility of symmetrically roots. This is symmetrical to this, or this is symmetrically, and this is symmetrical to, there is a possibility of symmetrically root. If there is a row of all zero indicates that there are symmetrically located roots on the S plane, the polynomial whose coefficients in such a situation, so that we need to form the auxiliary equation. So in order to, then if all zero exist, when all the elements in any row of the root array become 0, then it's difficult to form the root array. Difficult to form the S square row element, S to the power of 1 row element. Therefore, now we need to replace this zeros row. When all the elements in any row of the root arrays are 0, this condition indicates there are symmetrically located roots on the S plane. The polynomial whose coefficients are the elements of the row just above the rows of 0. Therefore, we need to find the polynomial. Auxiliary polynomial by utilizing the coefficients of the just above the rows of 0 in root array. We need to find out the auxiliary polynomial AS. So need to find out the, now difficult to form the root array. Therefore, this situation is overcome by replacing the row of zero in the root array by row of coefficients of the auxiliary polynomial generated by taking the first derivative of the auxiliary polynomial. Because of zeros in the array, the root array, we can't form the root array. This situation is overcome by replacing the rows of this row can be rows of coefficients of the polynomial generated by the taking the first derivative of the auxiliary polynomial. Therefore, this zero can be replaced by the coefficients of the auxiliary polynomial, differentiated auxiliary polynomial or auxiliary equation. So, therefore, we need to find out the auxiliary equation. Then determine the first step, find the auxiliary equations, differentiate the auxiliary equation, find out the auxiliary equation is. Differentiate auxiliary equation with respect to d by ds. Then take the coefficients of this equation and substitute here and construct the root array as usual manner. Therefore, now to find out the auxiliary equation, how to find out the auxiliary equations. The terms in the S cube row are all zero. The root array we can't form. Therefore, the auxiliary polynomial is equation is yes. Need to find out yes. Then be formed by utilizing the coefficients of the row just above the this zeroth row. Therefore, the coefficient of the row just above the zero row is s power 4 row. Therefore, the here there is 2 into s power 4 row. Yes, so that's 12 into s power square, s square row. Because this s power 4 row can be formed by coefficients of the even power. So therefore the s is equal to 2 into s power 4 row plus 12 into s square row plus 16 into s power 0, not s power 1, because this is a even powers row. So even powers row. So now this is the auxiliary equation. No. Now differentiate with respect to this. Differentiate with respect to s. So after finding the auxiliary equation, no, differentiate with respect to s. Then what will be the dA of s divided by ds? So is equal to 4 into 8s cube. 8s cube. 8s cube plus 12 into 2, 24 so plus 16. Plus 16 is a constant, therefore 0. Differentiation of constant is 0. Therefore, the coefficient of this equation, df s is equal to what? Coefficient is 8, 24, 0. Therefore, here we need to replace. The s cube row can be replaced by the coefficients of the differentiated auxiliary equation. Therefore, the coefficient of the differentiated auxiliary equations are 8. Therefore, s cube row is equal to 8 replaced by this 24, 0, 0. Now construct the root array as usual manner. After finding the coefficients, so find out the auxiliary equations. The auxiliary equation can be obtained by considering the elements of the row just above the this zeroth row. Therefore, the 2 into s to the power of 4 plus 12 into s square row, because it's a even powers row. So that is what I did not write here. 2 into s to the power of 4, 12 into s cube, I did not write, because it's a even powers row. Therefore, 12 into s to the power of 4 plus 12 into s square row plus 16 into s power 0. Now differentiate with respect to this. Find out the auxiliary polynomial. The auxiliary polynomial can be obtained by considering the coefficients of the row just above the, this row. Auxiliary equation find out madbeku. Hang find out madthira? Illi zeroth row ide. Zeroth row above ira row yadu s to the power of 4 row. A coefficient use madkondu auxiliary equation I have written auxiliary equation. Therefore the ಇದನ್ನು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದೆ. ಇದು 0 ಇರೋಗೆ ಅಬೋ ಇರೋದು ಎಸ್ ಟು ದಿ ಪವರ್ ಆಫ್ 4, 2 ಇಂಟು ಎಸ್ ಟು ದಿ ಪವರ್ ಆಫ್ 4 ಪ್ಲಸ್ 12 ಇಂಟು ಎಸ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಅಂತ ಬರದೆ ಲೆಕ್ಕ ಹಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಈ ಒನ್ ಪವರ್ಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಬರೋದು. ಎಸ್ ಟು ದಿ ಪವರ್ ಆಫ್ 4 ಪ್ಲಸ್ 12 ಇಂಟು ಎಸ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಬರಬೇಕು, ಎಸ್ ಕ್ಯೂಬ್ ಬರಿಬಾರ್ದು. ಯಾಕೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಎಸ್ ಟು ದಿ ಪವರ್ ಆಫ್ 4 ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಫಾರ್ಮಡ್ ಬೈ ಈ ಒನ್ ಪವರ್ಸ್. ಈರೋ ಆಗಿದ್ರೆ 2 ಇಂಟು ಎಸ್ ಟು ದಿ ಪವರ್ ಆಫ್ 5, 12 ಇಂಟು ಎಸ್ ಟು ದಿ ಪವರ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಸ್ ಕ್ಯೂಬ್. ಲೈಕ್ ವೈಸ್ ವಿ ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್. That is the very important. After finding this, you have to differentiate with respect to s. So when differentiate maadi adra band equations are coefficient alli parbidi, write down the coefficients. So then construct the root array as usual manner, and find the stability of the system. While forming the after forming the root array, here the zero. While forming the root array, when all the elements in any row, any one row of the root array are zero, this condition indicates that there are possibility of locating the roots on the symmetric roots on the possibility of symmetric root on the imaginary axis or on the real axis. So therefore, the because of zeros or row in the array, the root we can't form the root array, can't proceed to form the root array. This situation can be overcome by replacing the coefficients of the auxiliary equation polynomials generated by taking the differentiated. Here, take the auxiliary equation, differentiate this, and this coefficients are substitute here, and construct the root array as usual manner. Then observe the first column of the root array. If you observe the first column, there is no sign change in the first column. Sign change in the first column of the root array, then the system becomes limitedly stable because there is an auxiliary equation. That is what we go for saying. We can't say the system is stable. Is a limitedly stable. Oh, therefore, the given system is a limitedly stable system. Limitedly stable system based on the some value of gain k, the system is stable. Oh, that is what limitedly stable system. Given system is limitedly stable system. Therefore, there is a possibility of roots on the due to the auxiliary equation. There is a possibility roots on the imaginary axis or the symmetric roots on the imaginary axis or real axis. Therefore, those roots can be computed by considering the auxiliary equation. Now, this is the auxiliary equation. Then, auxiliary equation is the equation just utilizing the coefficients of the row just above the three row element. So, therefore, 2 into s to the power of 4 plus 12 into s square plus 16. Now, but just simplification purpose, go for dividing this entire equation by divided by 2. Now this s to the power of 4 plus 6s square plus 16. Now let x square is equal to x. So in order to find the how many roots are lying on the this right, I am lying on the imaginary axis. Need to find out s square is equal to x. So therefore, here you have to substitute s square is equal to x. So therefore, here x square plus 6s plus 8 is equal to, here there is a 6s plus this is 8. Now divided by 2, 8. Therefore, x is equal to, find out quadratic equation. Now find the solution, minus 3 plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. Apply the formula, then you will get the minus, so minus 3 plus or minus 1. No, therefore, x is equal to minus 2, x is equal to minus 4. Oh, then what is the s value? S value is equal to square root of plus or minus square root of x. So therefore, plus or minus square root of minus 2. Therefore, the s is equal to plus or minus square root of j2. Now this value is equal to minus square root of j2. Therefore, the and also another value is equal to s is equal to plus or minus j2. Now these are the roots lying on the imaginary axis. This is lying on the imaginary axis. So both are lying on the imaginary axis. So that there is a possibilities of roots on the imaginary. These roots are lying on j2 value, and also this is j2. Plus or minus j2 means it's a plus j2, and here j omega axis. This is minus j2. Here also there is a plus square root of j2. There is a possibility of symmetric root on the imaginary axis. So due to the auxiliary equation. No. Now we have find out these are the roots. So among the 6 roots, there is a possibility of 4 roots on the imaginary axis. So how many roots are lying on the S plane? How many roots there are there are four roads are lying on the axis. So the remaining two roads are lying on the left half of the S-plane. There is no route on the right half of the S-plane. Now this is the way of calculating the roots of the auxiliary equation. So this problem is very important to go through the class notes. So I have clearly written in my class notes also. What a similar type of problem will get it in the examination also. That is what you have to go through the class notes to listen this video frequently. Then you can easily understand this particular concept. So in the next class, I'm going to take another type of examples on the RH criteria. Thank you for listening.